Welcome back to Stick War Legacy. So there's something I've been wanting to try for a while. And some of you have been mentioning that there's a little bit of an Easter egg relating to Christmas. And that's, look at this. I'm pressing the tree. It's moving back and forth. So something's happening. Oh my God, it's Christmas. We shook the tree and we got 5 chests. Let's just go ahead and open them real quick. See if we get anything good. Maybe some of the new chaos spells. And then what we're going to be doing is we've got 2 brand new missions to play. One of them, we get to command one of the pretty epic bosses in the game. And guess what? Normally he's a bad guy, but he's going to be joining our forces today. So let's see. You see, if we didn't already have all of these skins, they would be pretty epic. I mean, that's probably the way it goes. Jeez. Yeah, like that one's worth 250 gems. That's pretty dang good. But I feel like if you're averaging 200 gems or more, ooh, we got America and a gold note. So all said and done, pretty decent. And the fact that like we were given these is a nice little Christmas touch. So if you haven't shaken the tree to see what Santa gave you, that's what it is, man. You're going to get some cool stuff. Now today, what we're going to be doing is check this out. The Kai hates the prince of the borderland flame feeders, and he's going to be joining us. So let's go ahead and see what happens in this one. Now I got to change my skins. We were just fighting zombies, so naturally I went with the savage skins. But in this case, I'm thinking we're going to go with just the classic leaf skins. It's my favorite. I feel like it has the most usability because oftentimes in strategy games, you can normally beat the enemy force if you have more than they do. So I'm thinking if we have the Kai and he's going to be sending out zombies, then we're going to want to support that with archers. And you know what? Mining never hurt nobody. And you know what? We'll upgrade a wizard because we haven't really upgraded the wizard in a while. Look at that. Okay. So let's see. Now, what are they going to do? Oh my God. Kai sends his regards. Is this army going to charge me? That's a problem. That is a problem and a half. All right, guys, go out there and defend him. And apparently we had a pretty decent army to begin with as well. So as long as they don't kill my Kai, I think, yeah, we're going to be able to stop this. Okay, so that's the prince of the borderland flame feeders. That's why he's a much larger spearton than the rest of them. Oh, yeah, we've got this. Now, they're fire skins, so actually archers may not be the best because my archers are just going to continually take damage, which is a shame because a very strong spearton like the prince here, well, guess what? I mean, it's bad news for us. Okay, so now what we're going to do is defend here. And we're just going to keep sending our zombies. And this is the time where, like, we need to invest in a wizard. And I should have gone all wizards, or rather all minion upgrades. So they're going to have a bunch of archers. The zombies are going to get cut down. I guess I could call in another Kai Rider, but, like, do I really want to do that? To just have, like, endless waves of zombies? I mean, part of me does want to do that, but I don't know if it's practical. I just don't know if it makes the most sense. And look at this. We're actually getting some damage. Unfortunately, we don't have any of the spitters, the guys who throw, like, the poison organs, which will then poison and do residual damage over time to these guys. But let's see how it works out. I mean, we're slowly but surely taking down those Speartons. One of them's almost dead. Oh, no, that's of course a Sword Wrath. Both Sword Wrath are almost dead. All right, so one wizard's in play. He's got 3 minions, so we will want maybe 2, because that way we'll do a decent amount of damage. And the minions, like, if they attack, they don't bring back the fire response damage to the wizard. So it's why they're a very effective weapon against the fire skins. It's kind of interesting. I guess there is a lot of like micro strategy to it all, right? Like if they're using these units, maybe you want this skin. It's just hard to plan ahead of time if you were, say, playing multiplayer. Granted, if you're playing a single player and they tell you you're fighting the fire people, you might be like, oh, maybe I shouldn't upgrade my stinking archers. Maybe I should have upgraded some guy that's going to be frontline soldiers, right? Strong Speartons work well against fire skins, but weak guys like Sword Wrath and archers, no good. So mistakes were made in the making of this video. So now at this point, I feel like, you know, Speartin or 2, something like that. It's probably all we really need here. So how are we doing? Oh yeah. We're about to bring them down because I've noticed that the Kai Rider, the longer he stays out there, the more zombies he'll send in. So now we're kind of at that critical mass stage where just so many are spawning in. And we're actually at like 42. Why are my miners? Miners, we need more gold, man. We need a little bit more gold. Then we can spawn in another wizard. Oh, we're unit capped. Okay. Well, we'll get 2 more Speartons and then we will push. Because I guess the zombies do. I wonder how in endless dead mode, how many waves you could survive with just like 3 Kai Riders summoning their own zombies to fight the other zombies. Yeah, we're at 51 out of 50. Although when the zombies die, I guess we'll get 1 more archer. 2 more archers. Oh, man. Now I want... Oh, my God. I waited too long. Okay, guys. We're going in for the final blow here. Let's do it. Zombies in first. then the minions, then the Spearitons. Now the Archertons will be taking damage. Watch at 4 damage. Each time they land and do 34, they take 4 back. So it's a net positive of 30, but you gotta keep in mind that your archers will die over time. Now when they hit the statue, they don't lose any health, which is just awesome. So Spearitons, zombies, and minions. I mean, talk about massive quantities of infantry. That's how you go. You could go well over the unit cap by doing that. Now where's the counterattack? Okay, they've got a giant. So we will pull back a little bit. Zombies don't care. Now we'll send in our force. Look at that. My guys are just slowly creating a nice phalanx here. Zombies doing most of the work. Archers taking damage. I guess Americ would be really good to use because he would keep your archers alive. That's definitely something you'd have to consider, you know, if you're playing and you had to be a little more adaptive. But yeah, I mean, I've got 2,300 gold and I have nothing to do with it because we're over unit cap and my Kai Riders are still back there. But look at how many archers are just dying over time. It's sad. It's so sad. They fought so bravely, but it's like they're being infected by what? Like a chaos virus or something? I don't know. I don't know what the lore equivalent would be of what's going on. So 5 minutes 23, not bad. And we got a new chest. So already today, we've gotten 6 chests. That's pretty epic. Let's go to the store real quick and unlock that chest, see if it's anything good. Oh, I actually have 3 chests. We'll open all 3 of them. And I'm hoping for a Kai Rider. Like, if I had to choose one that I'd want to get, it's a Kai Rider. How come that one was 25 gold? I thought it was 250. Maybe it was the Savage Giant skin. Oh, elite units of the East or West? That's pretty good. That's a good one. That's worth a fair amount of change. It's funny how the leaf skin is considered the cheapest one, but it's one of my favorites. All right, so now we've got the woodland tribes. So they're cheap units. And we're fighting Swordwrath and Archidons. So a lot of cheap Swordwrath and Archidons. And we're commanding Swordwrath, Archidons, and Spearitons. And we're gifted a Storm Lightning spell. All right, well then what I'm actually thinking we want to do is we want to counter the strategy we just had, right? So we're actually going to go fire, so their archers are taking a lot of damage. So the best thing to do here would be fully upgraded Spearitons, I think. Or at least high health Spearitons. Yeah, so we'll go all 3 there. And since our guys are more expensive, I feel like that's a pretty decent idea to put 3 upgrades into gold production. And I guess we're gonna have to go with 1. Okay. Oh, I've got 1 minute until sunset. Okay. Then I guess we're gonna get a little gold rush. We should. Okay. If that's. So we've got 2 lines of Swordwrath and 2 lines. I think I'm gonna need at least 6 Spearitons here. Can I get them in the amount of time we have with 4 miners? I mean, we did fully upgrade them, right? So it says 1 minute until sunset, but we essentially have 2 minutes total. I think that's kind of how it's working so far. We're working on our second Spearitan. This should be fine. Should be good, right? Right, guys? We're fine. We're totally fine. All right, how's the army shaping up? We're going through our military reforms and, you know, we went from guys with spiked clubs to now guys with big old round shields and nice sharp spears. Let's see. Oh man, we're down to the final minute. The pressure is on and I wanted 6 Spearitons, right? So I'm working on my 4th one here. Let's see. Oh no, it's gonna be tight. Leaf skin versus leaf skin could be good. We gotta remember that we're gonna do residual damage, right? There's no need to panic. We must keep our composure. Which is a little bit hard to do when you're staring down absolute destruction. I mean, look at this army. Look at that. These guys have a forest on their heads. Who are they? Where do they come from? The sun is almost down. It's setting. Come on, I need 2 more. There's 1. Da-na-na. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, we should be able to get a 6th one. And we'll see if that's the magic number that we need. Come on, guys. We're at 264. I need more gold. 6 seconds. I need more gold, Captain. Boom. All right. We're going to buy as much time as we can. And oh, we actually got 6. Oh, and we got a lightning spell. I'm going to see if I can't do it without using the lightning spell. Yeah, look at them taking the damage. They're only taking 2, though. Maybe I need to upgrade their attack, but we're about to break through their Swordwrath. Oh, yeah. There we go. Yeah, we got it. Easy peasy. Didn't even need the I almost said the lemonade. The lightning spell. How goes the war? The war's going well. If you're us. If you're the other guys, the war's over. Pack your bags, boys. It is over. So we do get a lightning spell, and I think we get 1 on each difficulty level. So this is one of the other ways, like if you're good enough and you don't want to have to use the spells, you can pretty much just like get 1 for each difficulty level, I think. Let's test that theory. And if we get the lightning spell and I don't want to use it, then honestly, let's try ice. Ice would slow them down. And I think icy boy archers would be good. Was that mostly Swordwrath? That was Swordwrath. So archers would be great. Maybe 1 or 2 Spearitons. And then, yeah, so we'll do this. Yeah. And so we'll have a few spear tins, but that's mostly just to hold the line. We'll get five. I don't know. And we'll use one miner rush once everybody's out here. Once all miners are in place, we'll do that. So we're going to have a little bit of a slower build up this game. Now that there's a little more time than you may think you have. It says 1 minute, but it's essentially two. All right. Now, once this last miner's out, because I want to get the most bang for my buck on this miner rush, right? All right. All miners are out in the field. Let's do a rush. Now, two people were already coming back, but they'll drop it off. We'll get the first spear tin. We'll get two spear tins, and then we'll immediately start archer production. And there we go. All right, things are going well. And if we wanted to... Oh, yeah, never mind, we're good. If we already got two spear tins and two archers, and we still haven't gotten under the 1 minute mark, we should be fine. Three archers coming right up, Captain. All right, and we are in the final minute. Now, we have slow building, and I think I would like Leaf. I like being able to rely on the Leaf skill, just because, I mean, you being able to produce more units always makes me feel better about the battle. How's this army shaping up? I mean, they got two lines of archers. That's gonna be tricky. Maybe ice was not the way? We'll see. We'll see. I mean, the only way we can really find out is to test it, to try it out. But I need at least, yeah, if they've got eight, oh man. I'm gonna need a few more archers than them. And I'll just have equal. I wonder if two spearchins will be able to hold. And then maybe at this point we just start pumping sword wrath as reinforcements. By as much time as possible. Oh my god, I accidentally clicked the giant spell. I accidentally clicked Griffin the Great. Dang it. That's lame. Alright, Griffin, you stay right there. I know I spend a lot of money on it, but I wanna prove that I can win this without you. Oh my gosh, Griffin! That was the problem with the spell popping out there. Let's see, would we have won this one? You know what, Griffin, I mean, if you're here now... Dang it! Yeah, so it popped up and I just clicked over here. Oh no. Well, Griffin, that was... Oh my gosh, that was the biggest mistake I think I've made in Stick War Legacy. Because check this out, let me show you how expensive Griffin is. Oh my god. Okay, so if we go to the store, and a Griffin the Great is 1,000 gems. Now, if we go to look at the price of a gems, oh god. Yeah, I spent about $10 right there. $10 on an accidental spell casting. Well, Stick War Legacy, guys, and we've got a couple more missions to do, so pull the trigger on the like button if you did enjoy the video. Subscribe if you're new. Let me know if you want to see more Stick War Legacy, and I'll see you in the next one.